Behind Nine Hills, where the moon was pink, there was a magical place in the shape of a walking man called the Comalake. It was the place where all the fantasies could come true, even the most unusual ones. It was the place where people started to believe in magic again. A young man, Federico, came to this lake in search for adventure. His wishes were not ordinary ones, as he was not an ordinary man. He was an old soul in the body of a young man. When he was a kid, his grandfather showed him the magic of sunrises. "Never forget, Federico. Every day is a new story," is what his grandfather used to say. Some say he had strange habits. He loved to do crossword puzzles in the elevator. Looking at the people who were waiting for the bus made him wonder about where will they go next. He loved standing at the corners of the streets where he felt like being at the end and at the beginning at the same time, just like in life. His first day at the lake, a water fairy showed up in front of his eyes. "Never doubt in the existence of magic. Do you have any wishes, Federico? I can make all your wishes come true. I would like to be an ice cream man and try 10 different ice cream flavors." And there he was, Federico, the ice cream man. After trying all the ice cream tastes, there was the other day on the lake. The water fairy showed up again. "You have any other wishes, Federico? I can make all your wishes come true." And that is when he started dreaming big. "I want to be a garbage man." And there he was, a phantom, driving freely around town like a superhero, which continued on the other night. He started falling in love with this place. He realized that Como is a place where you can be whoever you want to be and do whatever you want to do. Next day, as usual, he was waiting by the lake, but there was no trace, face or voice of his fairy. Federico was waiting and waiting, but the fairy did not show up. Disappointed, he decided to leave Como forever. While eating his last breakfast at the lake, he unexpectedly heard a well-known voice. "Federico, try eating with your eyes closed." Then, he realized that the magic was in his senses, movements, and feelings. It was all about the small details of life.
No.
His fairy was there with him, even though he didn't see her, he felt her presence. It was his last day at the Como Lake when he went to see the last sunrise. While he was floating on the water, he heard the voice of the fairy. "Never doubt in the existence of magic," were the words he heard through the waves. The fairy was somewhere around. As he closed his eyes, the town was waking up slowly. There was really something about this place. Paradise found once again.